The chickens are processed. They are sitting in ice outside. I am on vigilant watch to make sure no dogs go outside. Whew, that would be incredibly disappointing if they helped themselves to a chicken. Things went pretty smoothly. Robbie helped a lot, which was awesome. I was really proud and impressed. The girls are gonna help me inside now. We're gonna try to get things ready so that we can piece the chickens and vacuum pack what we want to. We're going to freeze some whole birds too. But something that I'm gonna do while we get cleaned up, because I can get it done in that time, is make some dog and cat food. I saved all of the hearts and livers here. I would eat this stuff, but no one else in my family will. So I'm not gonna make it just for me, but what I am gonna do is turn it into dog and cat food.
This stuff might make something that looks.
What are we doing, Bridget?
I'm doing the celery and I'm breaking the leaves off and the stems. We're gonna cut them and we're gonna eat them.
We're gonna make chicken stock, right?
Yep, we're making chicken stock.
Emmy, what are you doing?
Tearing up time for our chicken stock.
Absolutely massive chicken breast. Amazing.
All right, we are in the home stretch. How many do we have left, Courtney?
After I finish this one, we got four left.
Four more left. Four more left. So the harvesting part took, that's what we like to call by the way, the harvesting. It's a safe word on YouTube. So that took 4 hours, did you say?
Three.
Took 3 hours. I had to leave a little early. I had a soccer match. The good news is I got myself past the part that I was sweating the most, which is the, but I'm good now. I feel like I'm a pro. Courtney over here has been cutting everything up, parting it all up, and she's been doing that since what time?
Noon.
While I was out coaching soccer games. Oh, I worked so hard for you, honey. I worked so hard for you.
So hard.
But yeah, four more left after the one that Courtney has. We're going to time how long it actually takes her to finish one. We didn't count how long it took prior to this because, well, she was practicing. It was her first time doing it, right?
I've never pieced a chicken before today. I don't think I've ever even taken a bone out of a chicken breast, and kind of like a pro now.
She really is. I actually caught myself like watching her do this and sort of being mesmerized by the whole thing. I'm on the bagging duty, so that's my job. Bag, write down what they weighed. Right now we're averaging between 4 and 6 pounds. That's not even fair to say because we're not averaging four. It's more like 4, 12, and 6 pounds. For 7 weeks, that's pretty good. We fed them 24 hours. A couple times we didn't give them food overnight, but most of the time it was 24 hours a day. And again, birds go to sleep at night, so they weren't really eating, but at least when they woke up first thing in the morning, they could get the food right away, they didn't have to wait for us. And it worked out fairly well, especially since, again, we had to do this earlier than the 8-week time slot. We got the Homesteaders Convention next week. Week after that, I have a tournament. I think I said that earlier. So this was really our only window. And special thanks to Bigfoot Farmer for coming out, showing us how to do it, and, you know, getting through this process. Because honestly, if he hadn't, without that plucker, forget about it.
Or someone to show us how to gut a chicken. I mean, I've only done it like once. And I definitely don't remember it, so we would have been up a creek.
We really would have been up a creek, probably our own creek. We got up real early this morning. We started the whole process. We got out, set everything up. We got the scolder all set up. We actually used a turkey fryer for that, and it worked out amazingly. We put the cones on the tree. Those Bigfoot Farmer brought so we could use his cones. One was like a turkey cone, and one was meant for chickens. Courtney just told me she finished, so that was 7 minutes it took her to cut up that chicken. So that's kind of what we're going to gauge for our time. Multiply that by the 28 birds that we have. That gives us an idea of the labor that was involved in processing these birds at this point. I've been trying to keep track of everything, and I'm going to put a video out that shows you just how much did we spend, how much time did we put in, how did we figure out all that. So that way, the parts that we sell, we can figure out how much should it cost per pound. Now, the birds that we bagged as whole birds, we wouldn't calculate the labor in those birds. So I guess I won't multiply it by 28, just take all those birds out. Whatever, you get my point. Gotta do it, gotta figure it out. Gotta do this right, right?
Sure, whatever you say.
So let's see what one of these suckers is gonna weigh now. All right, Courtney, moment of truth. That one looks like a small one.
I think that's probably a 412 one.
It's probably a 412. Let's see. Wow. What do we got? What do we got?
5'2".
5 pounds, 2 ounces. Pretty good, folks. I've got, like, that's, seriously, I mean, you can't ask for better than that. I got really excited because we did this whole thing and I never even thought about this. Chicken wings? Come on. I love chicken wings. Yes. We parted them out all the way down to the chicken wings themselves, split those up, because this boy is gonna make some chicken wings. I love chicken wings. I eat them like chicken wings. I mean, well, how else to eat them? I'm not gonna eat them like candy. I don't eat candy like this. That's how I eat chicken wings.
That's how I eat candy.
It is how you eat candy. It's also how you eat pie and cookies and chips.
And chicken wings.
Cottage cheese. Courtney's a lip licker. Constantly. Anyway, we got the cones up. Those came from Jeremy. We got the plucker all set up. Jeremy brought that as well. Courtney set up her ice chests, which we just used plastic bins for, filled with ice water. And then we got started. Jeremy went through with me, you know, where do we get that chicken and how do we just kind of let it go? We let all the blood go into a bucket. Courtney was planning on saving all that to make some blood meal.
Yeah,
but we didn't have enough blood for it, so we ended up giving it to Jeremy for the pigs. After he got me started on that, I just kept going, kept getting the chickens, putting them in the cones, doing my thing. Then we would take them over, dunk them, get them in the plucker, get them over to Courtney to gut, get them in the ice. It was just a great system, and we just kept going. My son got involved. I'm very, very proud of him. That was something that he did on his own. He decided, hey, I wanna go out there. I wanna learn this. I wanna figure this out. So, wow, just unbelievable experience for us as a family to just figure this out, do it, raise our own birds. And I can't believe how much meat we have. I am so proud of us. Like, maybe not for you all, but for us, this was huge. This was a big, big, undertaking, something that we've never done before, something that's way out of our comfort zone, something we weren't sure we were going to be able to do, but we were able to do it. You know, if you're thinking about doing stuff like this, stop thinking about it. If you're able to get out there and do it, get out there and figure out how to make it happen, because you can do it and you won't know what you're doing. You're going to be overwhelmed, but that's okay. You can do it. It's not a big deal. Is it a big deal?
Nope, you two can rip the joints out of chickens. It's fine.
You can do it too! We are pretty much using every single part of the bird. Over here we have the hearts and the livers. That's getting cooked up. That's gonna be given to the dogs. Right here we have, what, the breastplates? What do we have in here?
There's a spine, some feet, you know, bones and...
Bones and other stuff. The feet, all that junk. That's all in here. That's gonna get cooked up in what? That goes for your stock, or what is that for?
Yes.
Okay, so that will be Courtney's stock. Funny, we're still rendering all of our tallow over here. That's an ongoing process by itself. Right here, this guy here, this is filled with all of our legs and our thighs and all the breasts that she's parted. Actually, this is like, what, the first, or like one of three batches of that, right? Yeah. So we've already got like a whole bunch in the freezer already. Funny story about the freezer. We actually ordered a freezer. Well, when I say we, I mean Courtney, without asking me. That's okay. We needed one.
We discussed it.
We discussed it, meaning she told me we should get one. And I said, yeah, probably. Let's look. We apparently looked real hard.
We did.
Yep. And she ordered it. But it didn't come.
Alexa, please call Kenny Archer.
Hey.
Hey.
Is the freezer on its way?
That's a great question.
You want me to stop at Dr. Supply and see if they have coolers?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, love you.
All right, love you too.
Bye.
Bye.
It didn't come after I went downstairs and ran a dedicated line to it, so that way it didn't blow any other circuits, because if you're gonna have a freezer like that, it should have its own line. We got some coolers with some ice, so hopefully that sucker comes real soon and we can get it all filled up. Not that I'm stressed out about that at all, but that's where we're at. Almost done, four more birds to go, and then we are finished with the birds. Do you need to cut them all up and part them? No. You could just bag the whole bird. I'm sure a lot of people just do that. We decided we are lazy folks who didn't really want to have to pull out a whole bird and butcher it all up that night whenever we wanted to eat it, so we cut them all up. Plus, a lot of folks that want to buy the meat from us, they're not really looking for a whole bird either. They'd also like to have it, you know, the way they buy it in a store. Fine, we'll do that. So that's what we're doing. Takes a lot more work, a lot more energy, but don't worry, I got Courtney a mat to stand on. She's doing a fantastic job. You're so wonderful, honey. I'll just keep bagging it. Bagging and tagging. Very last bird, folks. You're not gonna make it much longer. I'm pretty sure there is no bottle of wine that is gonna make this better. Mm-mm. But
we're trying.
We're gonna try anyway. Courtney, I'm really sorry, but as long as you're handling that knife, I don't know that you should be drinking wine. As long as you're handling that knife, I don't know that I should keep wine away from you. Good call. See, there's a very important job that I have. And that is this right here. Making sure that she doesn't get any chicken on her glass of wine. It's a tough job I have. Marking stuff down, bagging stuff up, tagging stuff up, and pouring the wine. You got this, baby. It's just last one. Last one. You're so close. How do you feel right now?
Like I'm completing an Olympic event.
Processing chicken. The new Olympic event.
Do you think that's a winter sport or a summer sport?
I don't know, but I think we'd be terrible at it since people process 100 in the time it took us to do 28.
I mean, for the record, we did only keep what? Like maybe like 4 or 5 chickens whole?
Yes. So that's kind of a big deal, right?
Yeah. But I'll be happy we did it later.
Oh gosh, yeah. you know, on Tuesday night when we're in a hurry and need to make chicken quick.
And I'm like, what was I thinking?
Whole chickens. Whole chickens, come on. That's silly. Look at that. I did such a great job bagging these birds. In the end, my chicken nuggets really weren't chicken nuggets at all. They were like chicken pound cakes.
Chickens.
You're right. They were chickens. And I'm not even gonna have any chicken nuggets, but I'm gonna have some chicken wings. Chicken wing. I'm gonna have some chicken wings. That was weird, but we're gonna put it in there anyway. We're delirious. Absolutely delirious at this point. This is a long day. Oh, this is my favorite part. Go ahead, let's see it.
That one didn't snap so well.
Oh, I'll do it again. All right, here we go. Oh, I heard it. One more cut. There it is. Come on, finish that cut.
Don't rush me.
It's not a rush. I'm just saying, if you finish that cut, you're done. You got this. I just stuck that in the chicken. Oh yeah.
All done.
Oh. All these workouts, so I don't know. All done? Oh, let's do it.
You don't want to high five me right now.
Chest bump. Oh, all done, folks. All done. Well, all we have left to do, folks, is to bag the rest of this meat, clean up all the mess in the kitchen, and that's pretty much it, right?
Yeah.
I'm so proud of you. I love you.
I love you too. Sorry, so proud of you. I wasn't making a face at you. My jaw really hurts. I think I was clenching my jaw.
Grinding your teeth?
Yeah.
Okay, it is gonna be 42 degrees outside, so I threw all of the meat inside of some coolers, put it out on the back porch so it can stay cold overnight. Then tomorrow, we'll transfer it from the coolers to the freezers, and everything is gonna be great. It's gonna be great. Thank you very much. We hope you enjoyed coming along on our first experience with processing our own chickens.
Whoop whoop.
We are super proud of ourselves, and we're definitely gonna have to do this again in the spring when the time comes around where it's good to do it, right?
Yeah, can we finish this first before we start talking about next time?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Thanks, everybody. Have a great day. See you on the next one.
Someday I'll find home. The picture in my mind. A place where I